Say hi, everybody. Okay, so we're going to show you how to use a ruler here today. And I'm probably going to sound a little silly to my class because I'm going to talk to the YouTube video and not to the class. So this is an inch on a ruler. We're going to pretend that the distance between this these two spaces, these two lines are an inch. You'll notice that on a ruler that the inch lines are actually the longest lines on the ruler. Do you notice that? Yeah. Look at your ruler game in front of you. It says 1, 2, 3, and those are the longest lines. Okay. The next longest lines that you're going to see on there are right in the middle, and they are 1/2. Okay. And that 1/2 is the reason that they have this, the longest line, is because halves are the next biggest segment. Okay. So the next biggest segment after that is fourths. And why do we call it fourths? Anybody know? What do we call them, fourths? Why do we call it halves? Yeah, they're divided into two spots, right? So how many spaces are fourths divided into? Four spaces. So this would be 1/4. Now, if we were talking about this line in terms of fourths, what would this line be? 2/4. Okay? So this one is actually more than one measurement on there, right? Or more that we can read that as more than one type of unit. We can read it as a half. We can read it as a fourth. We can actually read it as an eighth as well. So this would be 3/4. Okay. And the next shortest ones are the eighths. So if we call halves, halves, because they're divided into two, and we call fourths, fourths, because it's divided into four, why do we call it eighth? Because you're dividing it into eight, right? So this one is 1/8. What would this one be? 2/8. And then this one would be 3/8. And this one would be what? 4/8. And then this one is 5/8. And 6/8. And 7/8. All right, so now I can even get him into a smaller section, which is the one that you actually have to read on the ruler game. So if it's going to go, if you notice how we're dividing it here, it's going 2 and then 4 and then 8. And so what would the next one be? 16. So now we're dividing how many the inch up into how many segments? 16. So the smaller we get on our measurement, right? The more accurate our measurement is, the more segments there are in there. So now we have 1/16. And then you have 2/16. And then you have what? 3/16. And 4/16. And 5/16. And it's going to get really muddied up in here. But 3/8 would be how many 16ths? 6/16. Yeah, whoever said that. 6/16, and then 7/16, and then 8/16, and 9/16, and 10/16, and 11/16. I'm going to just keep going until it like beats into your head. And then 12/16. So 3/4 is equal to 6/8, which is equal to 12/16. And then, yeah, you're essentially doubling the numerator and the denominator in your fraction. So 13/16, 14/16. So 7 times 2 is 14, right? So 14/16. And then 15/16. And then finally, you would have 16/16. And 16/16 is not only equivalent to 1, but it's equivalent to 2/2, 4/4. And then 8/8, right? Okay, so if I said find 7/16, okay, you could go to 8/16, right? And then count back 1/16, and that would give you 7/16. So if I said to go to 11/16, instead of going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, because that's really slow, you could go to 12/16, right? And then count one back, okay? So when you're reading that ruler game, it helps to realize that the The bigger lines are actually equivalent to some 16th. Okay, so I'm going to upload this to Google Classroom shortly in my YouTube video. Thanks for being a part of my video. Class, say goodbye.